By the end of this video, we will have laid out the exact steps for you to create or upgrade your producer brand into a high status, money making and networking machine. We're not going to waste your time. Let's get straight into it. To put it simply, the size of your brand is the size of your network and your income. So the bigger and the more high status your brand is, the bigger your network is, and the more money you'll be able to make. Your personal brand will attract all different types of people, not just people in the music industry. With a high status personal brand, opportunities will open up to meet all sorts of successful people in a variety of different industries. The more you grow your personal brand, you will start to realize that there are endless possibilities and opportunities, whether you want to get backstage at an event or get into a specific studio session with a big following and a couple of messages, you can end up in some crazy rooms.
Here's why you should listen to us. In less than a year, we've grown our Instagram to nearly 2,500 followers, completely organic. On our main channel here, we've got over 3,000 subscribers. We have a second channel where we post daily cookups that we nearly have 1,300 subscribers on. And also, not to mention our old free loot pack channel that's nearly got 1,000 subscribers, which we haven't touched in 6 months. That channel has generated us thousands of dollars through collab sales and our paid products, as well as tens of thousands of downloads on our sample packs. This video contains everything we have learned ourselves on our own journey, as well as studying other musicians and influencers on why their personal brands are so good. So for those of you who are just like us and are serious about being a full-time music producer, we've got some sauce in here for you.
Boys, first of all, we're going to cover all the basics. First off, make sure you've actually created your producer Instagram and YouTube account, as these are the two most important platforms to grow your brand. This is a no-brainer, but make sure your Instagram account is public, otherwise you're never going to get found. Your username and profile picture is very important. For your username, try and claim the closest username to your actual producer name or whatever name you want to go by. Try and avoid using unnecessary special characters in your username. It makes it look really messy, so go for a clean, simple username. Your profile picture is extremely important. Your profile picture is what people associate you and your brand with. We have found the best profile pictures tend to be a photo of you, or at least something that represents you that just looks sick. Boys, a big red flag is having a logo for your profile picture. Leave the logo for your sample pack company and your clothing brand. Your personal brand should be all about you. For our profile picture on all our social medias, we have a picture of us in a studio as it relates to our brand.
The next basic principle, whether you're on Instagram or YouTube, is to show your face and your personality. The content you post, the way you speak, the way you act, your face, your whole personality, it just ties together as your brand, and it's how people will remember you. A faceless brand is so much harder to grow than one where you're showing your whole personality and everything behind the scenes. If you're in need of inspiration on how your brand should look like on YouTube and Instagram, go through some channels that you like, look at how they do their videos, look at how they do their branding, and same thing on Instagram. There are so many YouTube channels and Instagram pages out there that look super high status, and there's so many things that you can take and implement into your own brand. You don't even have to just take inspiration from music producers. Any other influencer you look up to and you think has a sick personal brand, take the best parts from their brand to put into your own. Lastly, boys, get rid of all of those old Fortnite videos on your YouTube channel. Take down those photos of your dog on your Instagram. We don't need any of that.
Now that we've covered all the basics, let's look at creating your high status Instagram. As we mentioned before, this is the greatest networking tool that you have in your arsenal in 2024. We've covered your profile picture and your username. The next thing you need to level up is your bio. We've noticed our favorite bios and the bios we think work the best are simple and clean. So if you look at our bio, we've literally just got producer duo, an emoji that we commonly use and represents our brand, and that's it. So you can take this approach by just putting music producer or producer. And if you want to add anything else on top of that, you can add your best credits or placements you've got, any cool accomplishments you've had, although there's a fine line between it being cringe or really cool. Having things such as multi-platinum, Billboard charting producer, with posts to actually back up your claims, looks really sick. However, things like the amount of views you have on YouTube, DM me for beats, multi-genre music producer, these things definitely aren't cutting it for a high status Instagram. The next thing you need to level up on your Instagram is the content you're posting. In terms of your posts, we highly recommend using the carousel feature on Instagram, meaning you can post multiple photos in one post. In terms of what photos to actually post, we recommend photos of cool looking studios, sick lifestyle photos, short video clips of doing cool stuff, and also placements you've landed. This is a personal preference of what placements you post, but for us, we'd only be posting the major placements.
Posting daily stories on your Instagram is a non-negotiable. Stories on Instagram is a super easy way to engage with your audience, and of course, you can sell products through stories as well. One thing a lot of people probably don't know about Instagram stories is that the more someone will watch your story, the higher up on the feed it will become. So if you're posting daily stories that people are engaging and watching every day, they're going to keep seeing your content and keep seeing what you're putting out there. That's how the algorithm works, so you may as well abuse it. And also your profile highlights. Highlights are a great way to organize your best stories into little categories, whether it's gym, travel, or everything to do with music. It's a great way for people to check out what you're doing all in one spot. Whenever people will visit your Instagram profile, they're going to be looking through these. So make sure you highlight only your best stories. We also like to go back through our highlights every month or so and just take out the ones that are unnecessary and don't look as good anymore.
Before we continue on with this video, there's two red flags with your Instagram that we need to cover. Number one, stop using those stock Instagram filters. To be honest, I don't know why Instagram still has these filters there to this day. They are all super outdated. You don't want to be using them. With a good phone, like one of the new iPhones, your image quality is already going to be really good. So with your posts, if you want to do any editing, we recommend doing them in the Photos app, increasing the colors and contrast. But again, skip the Instagram filters. And number two, use common sense when uploading stories or doing posts. Cut the pictures of your pets, stop spamming memes, no random selfies, no spamming type beats onto your Instagram feed. Just think before you post. Is this going to be adding value to your personal brand?
The second most important platform you need to be using to grow your personal brand. And of course, that is YouTube. YouTube is the best way to grow a loyal fan base that you can eventually sell your products and services to. In general, there are three different pathways you can take to grow your personal brand on YouTube. You've got type beats and sample packs, tutorials, and you've got general music content. We recently made a full YouTube video on the three best pathways that you can take to grow a successful YouTube video. So make sure you watch that after this video if you're serious about growing your YouTube channel. There are three key principles that you must be doing when it comes to running a YouTube channel. One, a great video idea makes everything else easy. We found that with a good video idea, the algorithm just takes it to the right people that need to be watching it. Number two, your title and thumbnail combination are super important. These are the two things that people will see when they're going through YouTube, and the same two things that will make them click. Your title and thumbnail are competing with everybody else's video that is on that screen, all competing for that one click. And thirdly, you need to give people what they came for. You need to make sure that your title represents what the content is inside of that video. Whether you're posting a future type beat or a tutorial, make sure you're giving the viewer what they came for. Make sure your channel stays niched. For example, on this main channel here, we've got tutorials and the occasional entertainment video, and we've got a second channel where we post beat and sample cookups. The audience on both of these channels are completely different, so it'd be a big mistake if we combined them into just one channel. That video, the three best pathways to a successful music YouTube, link in the description.
Now that we've covered what you need to be doing on those platforms, Instagram and YouTube, it is super important to make sure you connect your Instagram and your YouTube together as one big brand. Ideally, you want to be growing both platforms equally. We always make sure in our YouTube videos to mention our Instagram, pop up photos or videos from our Instagram. And likewise on our Instagram, we post stories about new YouTube videos we've dropped, which brings the people from YouTube over to Instagram and the people from Instagram over to YouTube, meaning your audience is going to be seeing a lot more of you. By getting your audience on both platforms and providing them with lots of value and content, this is going to increase the chances of you being able to sell products to your audience. So on your YouTube, always have your Instagram in your descriptions and mention it as much as you can, and make sure you occasionally mention a YouTube video on your Instagram story.
Boys, you've got all the information, you've got all the tools you need to start growing your music producer brand right now. However, there are two super important rules that you must understand before you leave this video. Number one, you always need to be looking for new ways to improve and be better. Whether it's the stories you're posting, the content that you're putting out on Instagram or YouTube, or just your general personal life. If you aren't always looking for ways to better yourself, you will never improve and you'll get beaten by the rest of your competition. Secondly, you need to understand exponential growth. If you haven't heard that term before, here's a graph of what exponential growth is. Exponential growth means that the results will just get bigger and bigger the more time that is put into something. At the very beginning, the results are very low and the time can be a lot more than what the results are. Over months, over years, and over decades, the results just heavily outweigh the amount of time you put in. When we first started our Instagram, we were maybe getting 1 to 2 followers a day if we were lucky. Now, we're getting 10 to 30 followers a day, and in 6 months' time, they'll probably go up to 40 or 50. So that just goes to prove that exponential growth is not a myth, it is completely true, and you've just got to put the time in first. All right, boys, that's it for today's video. We wish you luck on your journey to growing your personal brand. If you've got any questions, just hit us up on Instagram. We answer every single logical question we get on Instagram. Hopefully you took something away from this video. We'll see you guys in the next one.